November is National Family Caregivers Month, and to help those caring for family members with Alzheimer's, the Alzheimer's Association of St. Louis is hosting its annual Care and Conquer Education Series, and here to tell us more about it is Stephanie Rolfs-Young, the VP of Programs there. Good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon.
Okay, so tell me about this event and the importance of it.
So this event is for individuals who are concerned about a loved one's memory. Mm-hmm. They want to learn more about science and the research behind Alzheimer's disease, and also strategies to learn how to provide care for that person.
Yeah, because it's not necessarily the easiest thing, especially A, to accept the diagnosis, number one. Number two, to be a person who's caring for someone, because that could be draining on you as well.
It is, and we know that the journey of Alzheimer's is different for every individual that goes through that, but we know that the earlier we can find the signs of the individual's decline, get them connected to support, provide the right medications, the right diagnosis, that the better the quality of life is, both for the person with memory loss and the care partner.
Okay, so when you just mentioned signs, what would some of those be?
Well, we always tell people to look for memory loss that doesn't seem consistent with that person's normal behavior. Mm-hmm. So if somebody was great at math and now they're having difficulty, that might be a sign that something's changed. Mm-hmm. But we also want to look for confusion, disorientation, having trouble telling the same stories.
Mm-hmm. As far as the caregivers, is there more male to female? What's the ratio on that, or the numbers?
So the ratio is that more women are affected both by the disease as people who have the illness, but two-thirds of caregivers are also women. So we really want to make sure that women understand the signs, they understand the symptoms, and where to go for help.
Mm-hmm. Now, what do you think a person should do if they're first experiencing this whole being a caregiver? What are some of the things that they should learn or what they need to take away from your event?
Well, we want people, first of all, to know that they can call anytime to our 24-hour helpline number and get information about the disease, the stages, the treatments, and those types of things that will help them over a lifetime. But we also want to help families plan for the future. Mm-hmm. And we offer a program called Care Consultation where we can do a plan with that family.
Okay, so any other bits of information that people can take away?
This is a great time for Alzheimer's research, and we are learning so much more every day that we feel like the momentum is shifting, mm-hmm. and we want more people to be involved in the cause.
Now, here's a question, last question for you. When it comes to the ages, we'll get to your locations in a second, but the age range of it, I mean, mm-hmm. some people have illusions that it's always older people, but it can start younger, too.
It can. We tend to talk about the onset of Alzheimer's typically after age 60, but there are people in their 30s and 40s who have the disease, and that's why we need to all be vigilant about it.
Okay, so you have two events coming up. Tell me about those.
We do. So our Care and Conquer Conference is November 14th in East St. Louis at the Jackie Joyner Kersee Center, and November 21st at Maryville University.
All right. Thank you very much. I appreciate your time.
Thank you
very much.
Thanks.
All right, Dan, I'll send it over to you.
All right.